guys, welcome back to Tax Q&A. In today's video, I'll be answering all about tax audits. So let's get started. Okay, let's understand it like this. Say you're running a profession or have your own business, maybe a bakery. Every day you receive payments from customers against your orders, while also spending money on things like ingredients, rent, and utilities to keep things running. Naturally, you keep track of all these transactions in your accounts. Later, when you file your ITR, you deduct expenses from your total earnings and pay tax on net profits. Now, what if you start claiming expenses that are not even remotely related to your business? Like a center table that you bought for your home or a bicycle for your kid. See, a business can't claim random expenses, and to keep a check for such situations, a tax audit is needed. It is a review of the accounts of a business or profession carried out by a taxpayer. Now, of course, the ITD wants that an unbiased third party conducts the review, and hence, tax audits are done by practicing CAs who review the accounts and file an audit report based on their observations. Look, filing the ITR is something everyone has to do. It's where you report your income, deductions, and the taxes you're paying for the year. Whereas a tax audit is an additional compliance for those with businesses or professional income when their turnover crosses certain thresholds. They need to file their ITR along with the tax audit report. Not everyone. See, the applicability of a tax audit broadly depends on the scale of your business or profession. Let's start with the business. As long as your total sales or turnover doesn't exceed Rs. 1 crore, you don't need an audit. But as soon as your business grows and starts making more money, you'll have to get a tax audit done. To encourage the shift away from cash dealings, the government offers a higher turnover limit of Rs. 10 crores to businesses that do majority of their transactions in digital mode. Now, in case of professionals, a tax audit is mandatory if either the total earnings cross Rs. 50 lakhs or they're claiming more than half of their earnings as an expense. No, as I just mentioned, the criteria to decide your audit applicability are the turnover and quantum of cash transactions. So, if you have a turnover of say 11 crores and have losses, you'll of course need a tax audit. But if your turnover is within the limits, you can carry forward your losses even without an audit. As more and more people started to trade in the stock markets, this has become a very common question. Here's the thing. Income from share trading is classified as business income. So just like any other business, the need for a tax audit depends on your turnover. For stock market traders, the audit becomes mandatory if your turnover crosses 10 crores. This is because in case of share trading, all transactions are done via digital means, and hence the enhanced turnover limit. For most businesses, turnover is simply the total sales over a given period. But when it comes to stock market traders, especially those doing intraday or F&O trading, the calculation works a little differently. In this case, you calculate turnover by adding up the absolute profits and losses from your trades. Absolute here means you ignore whether a trade was a profit or a loss. You just add up the values without considering any negative signs. The resulting total gives you the turnover for audit purposes. There isn't an exhaustive list, as the CA conducting the audit may request various documents depending on your situation. However, some common ones include your bank statements, proof of expenses, and deductions you're claiming, and the books of accounts for your business or profession. Under the presumptive taxation scheme, you declare a fixed percentage of your turnover as profit and aren't required to maintain detailed books of accounts. Since there are no books, a tax audit isn't needed. However, if a business decides to opt out of the scheme within 5 years, a tax audit becomes mandatory for the next 5 years, including the year they opt out. For professionals though, this 5-year rule doesn't apply. There are two important deadlines to remember for a tax audit. The last date to submit the audit report is 30th September. Once that's done, the deadline to file your ITR is 31st October of the relevant assessment year. There are two scenarios here. First, you miss the deadline to submit your audit report. In this case, a penalty of 0.5% of your turnover or ₹1.5 lakhs, which is lower, may be imposed by the assessing officer. In the second scenario, if you file your ITR without getting an audit done, your return will be treated as defective and a notice will be issued. Nobody would want that, right? And I guess we've covered it all. If Google search is too much work for you, Quora is full of opinions, then you should check out Tax Q&A, where you can toss questions and our tax experts give quality answers. And hey, don't forget to like and subscribe so you do not miss out on what's coming next. Catch you in the next one.
What?
No. सारे कॉन्सर्ट के टिकट्स खरीदते खरीदते कंगाल हो गए हैं बट इट्स ओके नेम टू कॉन एक्सक्यूज मी डोंट इवन आस्क आई नो ऑल व्हेन वी टिकल आवर सेल्व्स व्हाई डोंट वी फील टिकलिश व्हाई इज इट दैट इफ ओनली अदर पीपल टिकल यू यू फील टिकलिश इजंट दिस अ जेन्युइन क्वेश्चन नेक्स्ट एक्स क्यू एन ए ऑन व्हाई दिस हैपेंस